It's time for Off the Air Live. And here's your host, Cody O'Connor.
What up, everybody? It is Off the Air Live, hanging out on a Saturday night in Manchester.
Manch Vegas, baby.
Oh, this is always a treat. Rob's here. Renee's here.
Hey, Renee.
Couldn't be happier.
What the fuck's good, douchebags?
Couldn't be happier. Taking a bunch of Adderall tonight. Rob's doing it for the first time.
I just took Adderall 30 seconds ago before the bumpers hit.
Did you eat it?
I swallowed it.
Cody, you're a fucking dumbass.
I know.
So,
look,
for
you guys
those
took
you...
way too long coming from Thousand Crane. I wanted to snort it, but
no,
we couldn't find my car. I didn't know where the fuck
decision.
I parked.
What do we mean you don't know where the fuck
no,
you parked?
No, seriously, you don't understand.
I totally forgot.
It was bad. We drove around for like 20 minutes looking for his car.
It's a fucking problem for me, man. Like, I'll go to the grocery store and I'll get lost coming out. I'm like, where the hell was
That's because you're always on Adderall all the fucking time. That's why.
Adderall is great. You don't know what you're talking about.
I don't know what I'm talking about. This is the very first time I've ever taken Adderall, and I'm hoping for the best experience. I honestly feel as if
I will be awake
for a long period of time.
I feel like the way you're talking about it, it's like you're doing some like major psychedelic.
No,
this is the first time I've done Adderall.
I hope this is a really positive experience for me. I've done coke, so... You guys do Adderall so goddamn
Adderall's
much that
better
I, feel like
coke.
I feel like I need to do Adderall.
Adderall's better than coke.
Thank you.
As someone
glad
who's
you said
also
that.
Done coke, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
And now there's some guy who just said that Adderall is basically meth.
Yeah, that's kind of
well,
weird.
Heard that in the news.
Well, I mean, it kind of is because it's the same... label all drugs the same category. Like MDMA, two different things. A lot of people don't realize that. Ecstasy, all different things. It's the purity. Meth, Adderall, different makeups, different chemical makeups, same family, but same effects, but less extreme.
Renee, what is better, meth or Adderall?
Have you done meth? Why are we asking all these questions?
Because you're the one talking about it.
Now I'm asking you the question. Have you done meth?
Okay. Yep, I did meth once. Okay.
Was it similar? Better?
It's similar.
Similar.
Shut up. I'm really
clipping
right now.
Can we get in the chat room now, by the way?
Yes. If you go to rebelloveshow.com/live and you click on live, you will see not only the LRN chat embedded on the website, but you will also see the Rebel Love Studio cam where you can watch us live while we're talking about your guys' addiction to Adderall.
Stop it.
Yes.
No. I went like for a month without taking Adderall. Good. And today fucked me up when I took it. Because I got 2 hours and I had to do a lot of driving, which is dangerous when you're running on like 2 hours of sleep. So it's good. It keeps you alert, keeps you focused. It's great. But, I mean, it's a little overkill, though, when you're going for 12 hours and the dehydration, the crash is starting to hit you, which is about where I'm at now. And I drank a bunch today, too.
Okay, here's my question with Adderall. I used to take an MDMA a lot. I've taken MDMA, I think, 5 or 6 times at this point, which is not that much things. But whenever I take MDMA that many times since
Porkfest.
I have taken it. Let me recount here. I took it my next time after Porkfest. My first time I ever took MDMA was at the Big Gay Dance Party, which was fucking fantastic for my first time.
It was.
I can't wish I was there.
That was your first time?
That was my first time taking MDMA.
Dude, my favorite moment about that, I lost you for a little while, and then I came back in. And as soon as I came in that fucking tent, I saw you with the biggest smile on your face. And I was like, all right, this is going to be a pretty fun night.
You have no idea how many times people came up to us and like to me and Anne, like within the next few months that people that like when we ran into them in meetups or like parties or something, they're like, you and Anne, you guys look like you're having a really great fucking time. I'm like, yeah.
Yeah.
We were having a really great fucking time. That was one of the best parties of my fucking life. Yeah. MDMA is fucking great.
I didn't even need anybody to dance with. I was
just
like, I'm so happy
by
myself.
You were dancing with your crazy face.
You took too much. I don't want to talk about it. Yeah, you took a little too much.
I took a lot.
You looked
practically insane. I had a girl come up to me who didn't know you. You were like dancing with me, and you just looked so insane that me and like walked me away. Said she needed help to go do something, just like get me away from you because I know who you were and that you were just like some insane dude like grinding on me.
But I was some insane dude grinding on you. I mean, that is kind of true.
He was some insane
that is kind of true.
It's, yeah.
I mean, you were.
If I were your friend, I probably same thing.
Yeah, you were very intense in your facial expressions of dance.
I'm an intense person, Rob.
Who isn't these days?
You have to be.
The Big A Dance Party was my my first interaction with MDMA, and then I saved the next interaction for Hempfest, which you fucking missed, which was an incredible festival.
I know.
You could have been so much Adderall.
You could have been camping out in the VIP section, getting VIP treatment. Free fucking tickets because you submitted the photo and all you had to do is like, bring your fucking car in a tent. That's all you had to do, and that's it.
Next summer, I want to do some festival stuff. But
yes,
I've got a list for you guys.
Portfest, obviously, but like, can we do a fucking music festival?
Zion Tiffic.
Hempfest is a music festival.
Yeah, it's all right. But I'm thinking more like Zion Tiffic, Wormtown, Strange
Wormtown.
Creek.
No.
I want to make pilgrimage to either Electric Forest or like Electric Daisy Carnival. Those would be like,
look,
blow my mind.
My thing is, I think for festivals next year, obviously Porkfest and Hempfest are on those two lists. I'm pretty much want to do it at least once a month during the summer.
Yes.
Wormtown is definitely on my list for next year.
Yeah.
And I got one more festival left, maybe in May or July is where I'm looking at. Because Wormtown in Mass, that's usually in September.
Okay, so but what?
Hempfest is usually in August. Porkfest is usually in June. That leaves July and May.
What is Wormtown?
Wormtown is basically Hempfest, but even more trippier, from what I've been told.
Okay. All right,
so as somebody who's been to Wormtown, Wormtown is a big-ass music festival. I think it's actually one of the last, if not the last, to bang out the year. Like, or end the year. Sorry, you guys. I'm super fucked up. I don't know how to speak English, but...
You had a lot of Blue Hawaiians.
It's the grand finale. No, I only had one. It's just
that's
a
mixture of
Adderall.
That's a lot for you. That's a lot for fucking you.
Yeah.
One Blue Hawaiian, you can't even drive.
Okay, yeah. So what kind of music are they doing? Like, EDM, rock and roll,
no,
jam bands? What are they
so
doing?
It's kind of like, I don't want to say indie, but Zach Deputy.
Mm-hmm.
Zach Deputy is the type of dude that's Zach there.
Zach Deputy. Shit.
Reggae. That sort of style, chill, like music.
That's cool.
But the beauty of seeing Zach Deputy or anyone else, if you're rolling on MDMA, odds are everyone else is either on MDMA or an acid or mushrooms or something
that. Oh, yeah,
everyone's fucked up. Everyone's dancing with each other. You can go around and dance with anyone. No one gives a fucking shit.
I would love that.
It was incredible.
All right, so I've got like a list of bands that I want to see live because it's one thing to have the scene, but there's some bands that are like an experience. STS9.
What is
there's
STS9?
There's
like,
this genre
like?
Called Jamtronica. It's basically EDM, but with like a live band.
Okay.
And you know what jam bands are, right?
Yeah,
like
yeah,
Fish,
yeah, yeah.
Stuff like that.
Yeah.
So there's this new genre called Jamtronica where it's like EDM, but also kind of a jam band thing. STS9, holy shit. If you get high and listen to them, they will blow you away.
Okay. I'd have to listen to them. Talk my shit, but I guess it was kind of a Jamtronica band, and it kind of sucked like a lot.
Oh, that's too bad.
And here's why. So,
are you talking about the Silent Disco?
The Silent Disco,
first
those
off,
girls.
You were so. Oh my god, I gotta disagree with you on this.
Did you take off your headphones?
Did I take off my headphones
while they were singing?
Because I wouldn't hear anything. The only time when I walked into the Silent Disco at Hempfest, the only time I heard people singing was before I put the headphones on. Once I put the headphones on, that was a different story. But before I put the headphones on, yes, people were singing along from time to time, and it was really odd. But once I put the headphones on, it was awesome.
Well, I've got more shit to talk.
I know.
Yes, but we'll do that right after the commercial break. More coming up. It is the Saturday Hotel. We are
in the Rebel Love Studios.
Yes.
Word.
Are you tired of your taxes? Fun,
they just put tobacco in.
So by the way, what are you thinking of this template I'm doing for you?
That's awesome.
Yeah, do you? All right, let me go. I thought I had something. I gotta go grab. Go to the other room. Hold on. Give me a second.
Anti-war.com.
Since time began, tyrants have taken aim at personal liberties. Now there's a movie that aims back.
This is how you live. How do you hate it?
The government has no right to tell us what to put in our bodies than they have to take our guns or tell us what books we can read.
The good stuff.
Six drug police were eaten by bears while raiding a marijuana farm.
On your knees, you dirty hippies! Jesus. On your knees!
What's the problem?
I don't know what to tell you. It's fucking water.
Laws do so only because it provides them with cushy jobs.
The only thing that sucks is something going on with this computer where there's like a second delay.
The drug war is nothing but a farce.
Is that what the chat room was going on about the other night?
Yeah, there's a lag switching between camera angles, and I'm trying to figure that shit out. So if they're anyone listen to Off the Air live on the YouTube channel right now or on rebelloveshow.com, I'm trying to figure out the lag issue. We bought this PC and it kind of not mean the stuff to it, but it's not coming up to where it wanted to be.
Rob, either way, like, just watching this video right here, it's fucking like, cool. It's really cool. Like, I'm legitimately impressed. Can we get the LRN chat room so we can read that?
Oh, yeah. Let me bring it up. You can bring it up. Just open up Chrome on my laptop.
All right.
Just open up Chrome on the laptop. Just go to rebelloveshow.com/live and you can get the LRN chat. Rebelloveshow.com/live. I just fucking fixed that. You just have to click on live. Now it's just rebelloveshow.com/live.
Free Talk Live is on more than 160 radio stations around the U.S. and has been downloaded on every continent around the world. Hundreds of thousands of listeners with
and then scroll down
from $600 a month to $6,000 a month.
I got a new website like 6 months ago, dude. I love the fact that you've been paying attention.
Well, who the fuck goes anywhere but Facebook? I know.
Look, look at my fucking website. I have to admit, I have one of the best podcast websites out there. Tell me a podcast website that's better than mine.
I'm legitimately impressed by this whole fucking setup.
Well, you know what? If you move to Manch, Vegas, you will have access to this website whenever you want. Well, not whenever you want, but whenever your show is live.
At any moment.
Yeah.
24/7.
24/7.
Give you a blog on Rebel Love.
I would put an off the air live category on the website where you can post to
the
website.
First thing I'm saying, Cody's can you, boobs
are. Renee, can you close this door? It's like blocking the camera. It's really cool. Look.
Dude,
you can see the door on the fucking on the camera.
I want to know what these people are talking about. First thing I see, Cody's boobs are bigger.
You do have big boobs.
Oh, I bet.
So so this means Cody is taking his clothes off again by the end of the show.
I never forget a thing.
FYI, Nate. Last time
here.
He was in the Rebel Love Studios, all of us were topless. But by the way, I'm fine with doing. I love getting naked in my own home.
I'm not right now. Nope.
It'll happen eventually.
Nope.
We need to get the weed going. Beer. I was promised beer.
I have vodka. Can you do vodka instead?
Yeah, I can do
we
vodka.
We didn't have time, Dan. We didn't have time to go buy a fucking beer.
Yeah, I know.
You were late. You like
I got here at the
late.
Nick of fucking time, right?
You were supposed
o'clock.
To be here at 6 o'clock. You got here at like 8 something.
I know. I just figured it's like, all right, it's New Hampshire people. They'll understand.
That's not bad. That's 42% of my books showing up.
All right, welcome back, everybody. It is Off the Air Live, hanging out on a Saturday night. Rob's here, Renee's here. Weed is in the studio.
That is herb. I don't know what you're talking about when you say weed. That is not the that is herbs.
Oh my god! The herb. God.
One love, everybody. One love. I'm gonna have fun.
Herbs, kids. Herbs. Here in the Rebel Love Studios in Manch, Vegas. Cody O'Connor's here. Renee Kate.
Hi.
I've been waiting all
the new
day
show
to get
of
high.
The new show Hicks, which happens
chips.
To be the name of a
stop
of a very popular punk band, but apparently because they're anarchics, they don't believe in IP, so they believe that they can take over that name.
I had Hold no up. Idea. I had no idea that was a band. No
it
shit.
Actually, a band.
But there,
which has like 10,000 likes on Facebook, and you guys have 200 likes. On
Number one, we just started that Facebook page.
I know. I'm impressed.
24
by
hours ago,
you guys
and
are
we
almost,
have 200.
You guys
likes.
Are almost at the amount of likes mm-hmm. that Off the Air Live has, and he's been on Facebook yeah. for like 5 years.
No, that's Ouchie. Actually that's actually very impressive.
It Suck is a dick, Cody. It is because we have tits.
It is because you have tits. Vagina sell in the Liberty Movement.
Now, as for Anarchics, the band is called Anarchics. Ellen and I are the Anarchics.
Okay.
Yes.
So what?
The Anarchics.
We're the Anarchics. We're not just any
Anarchics. I did appreciate that picture of hey. You, too, where you're both smoking cigarettes. I was a fan of that.
Yeah, yeah. Smoking was my idea. Thought it'd make it look more badass.
Oh, fucking nice. It might be 2015 going on 2016, but hot young women smoking cigarettes still look fucking hot. I don't
know.
Give a shit. That still looks fucking hot. It really does.
Glad that's still a thing.
You should be.
We're a demonized kind nowadays.
You're a what?
A demonized kind.
A demonized kind.
Smoking
is
cool.
Against.
Smoking is cool.
Yes, it is.
And we need to get back to that place in society where we believe that smoking is cool. Like, what
smoke
the fuck?
In the fucking restaurants. Smoke.
Yeah.
Smoke
bring
in the
it
back. Goddamn bars. Smoke in the bowling alleys.
Smoke in the car with your kids in the back. I don't give a shit. Bring it back. Make it cool.
I want
get your kids
to die of fucking cancer so that we can fucking smoke cigarettes. That's what I want happen today in today's age.
It's yeah, well, you know they complain all the time about the number of people dying from cigarettes. And yet overpopulation is like a thing, right?
It's a myth perpetrated upon us by the state.
Maybe
that's what
it,
doing
maybe
about,
it is.
That's what they're
maybe
doing about
is,
kids dying of cancer with cigarettes. You know what?
I can still either way, I can still get behind the idea of there being less people. Hands down. I still believe, like personally, I don't care about the science. There's too many people.
Well,
so,
I hate everybody.
So
I feel you.
I don't know why we're so worried about all of these cancer deaths.
You can
we
move
need more
to
of it.
You can move to like a tiny little populated area.
I might.
Where would you? Where the fuck would you move? Like you're already in a small town known as Portland. Where the fuck would you move? What smaller city would you move to?
I wouldn't. All right. If it was totally up to me, I wouldn't move to a city. I'd move to an island that was totally just me. Totally
Why?
Just me.
Because everybody
Why?
Fucking sucks.
I mean, how the fuck would you, like, you know, rub around? Like, how would you have sex with other people? How would you rave? How would you go to big gay dance parties? Like, how
is,
the fuck would that happen if you lived on a fucking island by yourself?
All right. Here's part two. I've got a boat. The boat goes to Party Town. It's on a bigger island. Everybody's half naked. They're smoking weed. We rave. We get naked. Drugs. And then when I'm done, I go home and just have my solitude.
Why would you go home after a bunch of sex and drugs and orgies? Wouldn't you stay there and fall asleep?
No. That
I kind of want to sleep in my own bed.
Yeah,
I
and it just bad. You know what I'm saying? Puts a bad example out.
What's the bad example? How is that a bad example? I think that's
well,
an example that we could, I think that is an example that people can live with. Like, why is that a bad example?
Because if I'm just going to fucking party with you, I probably don't like you. I'm just fucking and partying with you. So I'm going to go home and sleep in my bed. I'm not going to give you the wrong idea. Bye, Felicia.
I'm so fucking sick and tired of you saying bad, Felicia. You've run that into the ground.
Oh,
you need to come
no,
up with a new,
dude.
You need to come up with a new fucking
nope.
like slang.
Hold up.
A new fucking. You have run that in fucking
hold
ground.
I'm going to have to agree.
All right.
Because here, if
it's
this
like every
was,
conversation with you at this
Renee,
point.
If this was your thing that you did, and it was yours, and you owned it, that would be cool. That would be original.
Fuck your IP.
Do you even know? Do you even know how many women that I know that think that that bit is so fucking funny?
I don't even think it's that funny. I think it's funny when I piss other people off by saying it. Bye, Felicia. Anyways, no. So I have a really good story about this the other night. I was outside that happened to be inhabited by anarchists. And
are you Quill?
Yes. And my boyfriend and I were outside smoking a cigarette. A few of us were. And we had a few drinks in our hands. Cop pulls up. Hey, how you guys doing tonight? And we're like, hey, aren't you supposed to be looking for criminals? What are you doing? He's like, well, you guys are standing in an alleyway. And we're like, no, we're on private property. We're in the driveway, so you can get lost. And this guy just kept like going on and on, trying to get information out of us. And we obviously just turned our backs. And finally, he's like, all right, you guys have a good night. And you know what I said?
No. What did you say?
I
said, bye, Felicia.
I said, bye, Felicia.
Okay.
And the look on his face was goddamn
priceless. I'll give you credit. That's probably a cool way to say bye, Felicia.
And I didn't even force a habit, so I'm glad I do it.
All I'm saying is you've run that into the ground. You need to come up with a new catchphrase.
No.
Bye, Felicia is done and over with. This is an intervention. This is an LRN intervention.
That's true.
All right.
I think what we should do at this point is take a poll in the chat room. See how many people think that this needs to end tonight.
Nate, if you love Off the Air Live, you will vote in favor of ending Renee's crusade in favor of Bye Felicia.
This might not be good, though, because people in the chat room do seem to really like you.
I don't know why.
So
they,
it might be because you're 18 and blonde and hot, but who knows?
Or it's because I don't fucking suck like you guys.
Wait, how the fuck do we suck?
Well,
seriously,
FYI,
you're talking to a couple people who have a couple of the bigger shows on this network.
I love how you put a quote unquote the bigger
the
shows.
How
many likes do you have on your Facebook page again?
It doesn't matter.
It doesn't matter.
First off, I have double the likes of both of your guys'. So
it doesn't.
That's okay. And I had to rebuild my Facebook page.
That's great.
From six months ago.
You lucked out
I had to restart it.
I'm proud of you, Rob, but here's the thing. I'm the headliner on LRN.FM.
Are you?
The big deal.
You are.
People are excited to fucking listen to my show.
You do have a good show. I won't lie. I love your show. I listened to your show longer than I've actually been doing my show. So I'll give you credit.
I don't do the social media thing. That's your forte, all right?
I have a forte
but
in social
I don't,
media?
I don't need the Facebook likes to Neither fucking tell me that that my show is a hit. I know it for a fact.
Oh, no. Yeah. You have a hit. I moved here to the Shire because that was fucking awesome, people dude. Around who take liberty just as seriously.
I'm getting stoned.
So anyways, dude, do you like this theme? Do you like what I wanted to show you this before we went to dinner. I don't know if you liked
it. Dude, I'm in love with it. Like
I want to figure out how to make
this my fucking break screen like every time.
Okay. Well, if you move to Manch Vegas and move to Rimmon Heights, you can use this studio every Saturday night. And you can have this theme and you can use this every fucking night. You could have this you could broadcast live with this theme every fucking night all the time.
Man, is that fucking tempting.
I mean seriously, every fucking night. Every fucking night you can have a fucking galaxy spinning behind you. Talking and smoking pot, like while you hear Ian talking about
that
Shire
Society.
That would
be so fucking great. Every time I'm getting all Liberty Shamany, that's gonna be behind me. Talking about the true natures of the universe.
You're not close enough. You gotta get on camera. This is a tiny studio.
What's up, everybody?
Yeah, this is I want this the Rebel Love Studios. All right. I want the Rebel Love Studios to be the Liberty Media capital of the world. This studio, this room. If you moved here,
that would chink it.
That would get it.
Seriously, where are the headliners? Both of us, our shows are
live.
The headliners. No, well, Free Talk Live is a given.
Yeah,
but
besides Free Talk Live, I mean, there's Freedom Fiends on LRN.
The cool thing is, everybody's still kind of sober when Free Talk Live is on. You know, they're all political, whatever.
I love then the fact that both of our shows, are not, we don't take our shows seriously. And I love that about both our shows.
But it's part of, like, the time. Because, like, everybody in the chat room, they're getting fucking blazed. They're getting fucking drunk. Like, they don't want to have that, like, rigid
Free Talk Live type of show. It's one of those things where, in regards to Free Talk Live and everything else, it's one of those things where Free Talk Live and other shows are very philosophical. They're very they're educational. We're not fucking educational shows. We speak to the we speak to the enlightened. We speak to the ones that are already awake. You know, we're not the ones talking to the people that are listening on like AM 560 in Chicago or some other weird place or some weird AM station that no one's fucking heard of that Free Talk Live is on. Yeah. All right. We're speaking to the people that listen to Free Talk Live, woke up, considered themselves fucking anarchists, and like, now what the fuck do we do? We're literally placating to that like fucking little tiny niche of the little tiny corner of the internet. That is where we're fucking focusing on.
Yeah, but you know? Let me tell you though, the people that do find us, they really appreciate it. I've gotten so many like messages on Facebook from people I've never met, just saying like, dude, you're like the only show I can listen to. Like, everybody else is full of shit, but
no, I've gotten that too.
That whole, like, dude, you fucking get it. I get it, you get it. This is fucking awesome.
Yeah.
Like, but that's what happens, you know?
No, I hear you. It's weird. Like, it's hard for me to listen to like, normal Liberty podcasts. Like, it's almost to the point where, like, I don't give a fucking shit. I already know this shit. I don't need to keep listening to the same thing over and over and over again.
Nah, man.
There was a time. Like, I talk about stuff I want to talk about, not stuff to like try and teach someone to learn. Like, this is why you should be free because of like blah 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 blah. Like,
you already know that.
I already know that. Like, you didn't discover this show because you were learning it.
And bottom of the fucking hour to you guys. It is Off the Air Live, hanging out on a fucking Saturday night. Rob's here.
We're in Manch Vegas.
We're in Manch Vegas, and I'm getting fucking blazed right now.
I have taken so many drugs today, I've lost count. I lost count.
All right, so we're a half hour in. You feeling that Adderall yet?
A little bit. I'm feeling a little warm. Is that a normal thing? I don't know.
Yeah,
I
feel like it is.
That's basically where I'm at this point. Like,
I
what did I take? I took a pill. I took a pill of Adderall literally 30 seconds before the live bumpers hit at 10:06. I'm sorry, 10:06. Ian, don't hate me. I still haven't printed out the fucking show clock. Don't be full profit on me.
Can I just tell you that you guys are fucking idiots?
Why do you say that?
Move. So, Adderall. So, you took this at, like, 10 p.m.
Renee, you know you're going to be up 24 hours with us. Don't be fucking bullshitting with us anyway.
Nope, I took mine at 8 a.m. I'm tired as fuck.
Yeah, you're going to take more. You know you're addicted.
I think I'm good. I'm not addicted to Adderall. Now, there are two forms of Adderall. You can get it either instant release or extended release. An extended release will last you 12 hours. 8 to 12 hours. I have been fucked up since 8 o'clock this morning. Now, you are not going to sleep tonight, bro, unless you've got some serious willpower. Cody, last time I was over at your place and we were sniffing Adderall all night, we tried to go to bed. We were up till, like, what? Fucking, like,
dude,
10 o'clock in the morning?
We were up until 9 in the morning.
Yeah, it was, like, really stupid. Like, Adderall does not allow you to sleep. It keeps you awake.
Look, I took this knowing damn well that I'm not going to sleep. Like, tomorrow, I get to deliver. Thank families and needs. Wow, I'm still awake 24 hours on Adderall.
Dumbass.
I gotta say, I'm pretty pumped that you're pulling an all-nighter tonight.
Yeah.
I think I'm gonna do it too.
How often are you in Manch? I will stay up with you.
I'll try, but
you got
my
this,
boy
Renee.
And I are gonna be drugged out. Okay. Sorry, by the way, you guys. I know Cody's fans will
question.
Be so disappointed I'm leaving at 11 o'clock, so enjoy me while I can.
Why weren't you doing mushrooms with him?
So, I do a lot of shit like that, and I just can't anymore. My body does not handle drugs the same as it used to. Very receptive now, not so much. I can't smoke pot anymore. For those of you who do not know, I was drugged, and now it's not a, I don't know if it's PTSD related, but my body physically does not have the same reaction. Instead of being chilled out and like feeling good, I fucking panic. And I don't mean like get paranoid. I mean like panic and convince myself that I'm dying and time stops. And it is just the scariest thing.
I don't want to be an ass, but I think it's kind of easy. But here, what I've
I'm not blaming the drug. I'm blaming my body.
But a lot of people do that. They'll say like, "Oh, weed makes me paranoid." What weed does is it makes you aware of the fact that you already were paranoid.
Well, here's the thing. Drugs,
you know, like those shitty feelings that you're kind of pushing away. Hey, this is who you are as a person completely. I get fucking anxiety all the time when I smoke weed. Because I've already got...
Drugs, you know, work different people. Like you were saying, it took you a lot of Adderall the time I was out there. Took me like two lines and I'm good to go. You needed like a half or something stupid. Like we did all my Adderall and you did most of it. So, I mean, you know, drugs work differently on different people. Maybe I'm fucking wrong, Rob. For all I know, you could just pass out at some point tonight.
Dude,
with my exact knowledge, right. I don't think so.
Can I stop you for a second? You're totally still.
Yeah.
Like, I'm perplexed watching your eyes dart back and forth as you fucking talk. You're like.
All right. I want to know because I'm not there yet. What should I expect? You know, what am I in for the next like 10 hours?
Just be, you'll be excited. Did you see my status earlier today where I was like,
your status has
so
pissed
happy.
Me off so much. You've like, you literally have been like literally bleeding happy hardcore onto your fucking wall for like the last week. I don't
I've
know
been
how
happy.
Much fucking Adderall you've been taking, but you've been literally bleeding it out onto
Did you
your
see
wall.
My status this morning?
Maybe. I don't know. And there's a lot of
status. It was a status about how I'm so grateful for all my friends. Me and how I love Jazzy and how my boyfriend's been so good to me and how that everything's going so well.
Of course you're not excited about fucking Riker, who you just literally you abandoned him as the fucking parent.
What the fuck are you talking about? I take the dog out all the time.
No,
if you guys aren't
take
home.
The dog out. When was the last time you took Riker out for a walk?
Last night.
Okay, before that, you're never fucking home. You don't take care of that dog.
Yes,
me and
I do.
Ann take
before
care of that
Before
that, dog.
It was when you guys were in Boston, which was not too long ago. That was a couple days ago.
Okay, I take that dog out like 3 times a day, every fucking day.
You guys are here. It's your dog.
It was our dog, Renee.
I like
the only reason why
Riker,
I agreed
okay?
to get that fucking dog was because it was a polyamorous adult parents relationship with that fucking puppy. That was the only reason why I agreed to get that puppy. And
look,
literally a week after, you're like, "Oh, I'm Renee. I'm gonna be in Keene and everywhere else for like a week at a time." And literally 2 weeks in,
my grandmother just fucking died. You
no,
asshole.
No, that had nothing to do with your grandma dying.
We got that dog the day before my grandmother's funeral. You fucking douchebag.
Okay. Well, regardless of that. Going forward after that, it's been months afterwards, and you don't take care of that dog.
Yes, I do. I do a lot more than you think. That dog is let out whenever you guys are not here because I don't bother to message
you
guys.
You don't care about Riker. You don't care about
Yes,
Riker.
I do. I do care about Riker. I would never let anything bad happen to that dog. I love Riker, but
okay.
I'm not going to lie to you. It's not a competition.
Look,
Jazzy has a very special place in my heart.
Look,
that is my baby.
I won't lie, Renee. The only reason I accepted the fact that we're going to get that dog is because Anne made me that agreement. She made me an agreement. If I gave her 5 years, folks, look, if your fiance says, I will not have kids for 5 years if you give me a puppy. You ask that woman or man, where do I fucking sign?
Yeah, exactly.
That is the reason why we have Riker. That is not because of you, but I am saying that you said
and
that
you love you,
oh,
your
love
daddy.
That dog's adorable.
Your daddy.
That's
and
one of the coolest
mom.
Dogs
that's
I've ever had.
Ann's baby, okay? Like, that's your guys' baby. I like helping you guys out as much as I can. I don't want Riker to be chilling in a fucking kennel all day if he doesn't have to, if you guys are both at work or out, whatever you're
have
doing.
Have you taken him out
I
for
take
frisbee?
Him out.
Have you gone throwing a frisbee for him?
I have, the new yellow one.
Yeah.
And at first I was playing with the dirty red one that was in the yard because
yeah,
he liked it.
Fuck that shit. That is way inside base. I'm sorry, Craig. We're hijacking your show.
He took over my show once. He can fucking deal with it.
It's kind of fair. That's true. That was a good moment, too. I was pretty happy about that.
What good moment?
When she hijacked your show?
No, when I hijacked your show.
Fucking douchebag.
Yep. Happened, though.
You're
that
a
was
douchebag.
Awesome. I actually was listening to that when that happened. That was beautiful.
Bullshit.
I praised the prophet for pulling that maneuver. That was Ellerin gold. There's not often.
I may be a calm Liberty shaman.
As an LRN like super fan, that was LRN gold when he pulled that off. You know, for like the 50 plus listeners out there that was listening live at the time.
8 hours before a show, I'm like, Ian,
awesome.
Can you get these bumpers in? Yeah, midway. And he's like, oh, I don't know if I can do that, but I'll do my best. Meanwhile, the show's going on.
Hey,
Ian's like, oh, I can change to Renee's bumpers into Cody's bumpers.
Yeah, that was awesome. Hey, Renee, I gotta ask you, is the Anarchex or the Anarchics. So is this gonna last? Is this gonna be a thing? I really love the Anarchics.
I would
I want
like
them
it
to,
too.
I want the Anarchics to be out of the Rebel Love Studios. I want that to
I
happen.
Want
I want
this
that
to work.
Be...
I would much rather Rebel Love Studios. There's a lot more to do in Manchester. The studio is superior. Green screen. Sorry, Andrew, but it's the way it goes. So I hope so.
All right. More coming up.
Check that for a little while. I'm sorry.
No, it's good. I'm like, I'm coming into a very weird high right now.
Uh-huh.
Yeah.
Okay. Anyways, would you like to take controls of changing the camera angles?
How do we do it?
Okay.
One, two, three.
So I have, no, three I deleted as a shot. So three actually doesn't exist. One is, if you switch to, it literally just goes to your, the chroma key on this. Why is the fucking chroma key like that? Oh. Gender break here. I don't know if you're reading the chat. They said something about you at one point. Yeah. The screen was literally pointing it to you on here, but you weren't paying attention.
Dude, what the fuck? The chat room just refreshed and a bunch of people said stuff to me and now I can't.
The whole world is going to a world collapse. They said we have.
Oh, perfect. Okay.
We have till the.
So what I want to know, Ginger, is do you know who Paula is? You've given me the collapse in less than a week. I'm gonna start drinking.
Okay.
Now. Buddy,
if you one, two, four, and five are us. No one. Three and four are us. No, one is the original logo. Four is us. Five and six is Renee. If you hit seven, is the camera. That's that camera right there. Oh, but that's all fucked up. What the fuck happened? It's so light like that. If you're listening at home and you're starting, if you want Volunteer's polyamorous late night radio show, as in the Rebel Love Show, fuck, it's a lot of fucking. And using a chroma key takes a lot of fucking effort. I'm trying to, if you're paying attention to this live feed on rebelloveshow.com/live, it's not easy. Why is this not cheaper? We'll match that price and ship.
Come to the conclusion that it like keeps hitting me in bursts.
I'm doing them. Changing. Automotive. This is what I.
10 right now.
This is like freaking me out.
Shop.lrn.fm. You doing now?
I'm trying to normal key on the tree that shows the studio. I'm not paying attention. I'm trying to fix it. Oh, it's Derek. I'm trying to put it back on source 1. If I source 1, it just goes so I can edit source 7 headshot. Shot to feel that's the overhead shot is kind of that be my that's my Deadpool shot that breaks the fourth wall, because if you look at all the other shots, they're just straight at me and you or straight at Renee. So all those shots, you only see the green screen. You don't even know that this like fucking studio is here, that this fucking wall is here.
Yeah.
All right. And then I just fucking throw it out. Like, no, these green screens aren't really real. They're just the visual effects. But even then, if I throw it out, there's still a fucking green screen behind us. You see that? You see this fucking thing right there?
We are off there Saturday night. 10:47 of the show.
Here in Manch
Vegas. Here in Manch Vegas, and fucked up now.
How fucked up are you, Cody? Because you're always fucked up on air, but how fucked up actually are you?
Pretty fucked up right now.
That's pretty.
In a good way.
The most fucked up I've ever seen you was at the dance party. I won't lie. Fucked up part I've ever seen you.
It's weird, man. I don't do drugs well. You know? I usually have a time doing drugs.
You took LSD from Strangers Off the Street.
I don't even know where it is.
You took off of Strangers on the Street. You know your drug dealer on intimate basis. Start buying LSD from them. I
literally found it.
Oh my God.
Honestly, I'm glad, because it was like Bad News Bears, man. Dumb shit. I think we've been doing a long time.
For so many, like, we, it's like I've gone too far.
Yeah, I know. What are you doing?
I can't back all with this whole idea that's gonna screw me out of $20.
Let's go get the money. I'm like, what are you doing? I'm like, don't buy drugs off of strangers on the street, you fucking moron. He's like, well, it's too late now. The money's in my. Oh, not really. Go back down. He's like, no, I'm doing it. I'm like, all right, guess I'll make sure they don't jump you.
I learned my lesson, though. The other night, I met the nicest fucking drug dealer I ever met. Talking about Molly. He was talking about cocaine. It's not really cool. Again, with champagne, drunk as fuck, and I gave him a big old hug. But man, I'm good. I convinced people. I let him go. I totally could have bought so many drugs, I didn't, because I didn't fucking know the guy.
And then what did you do tonight, Cody?
What did I do tonight?
What'd you do?
About 3 Adderall.
And what else did you do tonight, Cody?
I was given a couple fucking hand-rolled cigarettes. Is that weird?
I mean, the joints you bought for $1 from some stranger on the street?
They just wanted, and they were trying to find a way to me.
With some joints that weren't actually joints?
$1.
Silly.
It's a fucking.
That's not the point! You didn't learn your lesson! You can't just buy joints of people you meet on the street. Not day and age anymore.
I'm giving them a donation and they get a tip. All right.
They still lied to me.
wasn't buying. No, they just wanted 20 cents for some fucking weird reason. That was their compensation.
They had some junkies tonight. Good job, Cody.
20 cents. What the fuck? You get junkied up on 20 cents.
That's what they do this to tons of people. Just one of 20 people that they asked within 20 minutes of you buying two joints that weren't joints. Actually, just some shitty hand-rolled cigarettes.
I really don't.
Oh,
I'm out of I'm out a dollar. Great.
I don't give a
dollar. I'm out.
I
was.
It's not
even
you, bro.
It wasn't even my dollar. It wasn't even. All right. I'm.
Were they actually?
Whose dollar?
Were they actually drugs?
What the fucking? Oh, they were. They're hand rolled. They're actually nice cigarettes.
Ah,
but you know, who gives a shit?
Guys, I'm tweaking so hard right now.
I'm actually about this Adderall trip.
Dude.
This is the first time.
We're going to be up all night.
I don't mean to freak
we're
you
gonna
out.
Play, we're going to play gonna fast techno after this.
Fast techno.
Fast techno.
I'm down for that, but I don't know, you guys. I am not a fan of time release. I thought I was going to be. It was only 20 milligrams.
Okay.
Or 15 milligrams.
What I want to know from both of you, when you do Adderall, what's something that you really want to do? What's like the thing that you want to do?
Dance my ass off or just run. Just
run?
You really want to know?
Yeah.
8 hours of porn. Fucking eight straight hours of porn.
All right. Running a personal here, what? Cody. I want to know how much, when you do Adderall, and it's an Adderall porn trip, because I really love watching porn while taking edibles. I get a really good body high. It's fantastic.
Oh, yeah, totally.
All right.
Like, I
so
fucking
how
connect.
Many, we're going deep. How much, how many times do you like to come when you're watching porn on Adderall? What's the average?
One or two. I try not to empty myself all the way, you know?
Why not?
Because then I'm empty.
It's not like you don't replenish.
You're excreting your man juice, all right?
Yeah.
Takes a lot for your body. It takes a fuckload for your body to produce semen. So when you fucking drain that shit out.
Women don't appreciate that shit.
When you drain that shit out,
you become. They think we're just like fucking shooting it out left and right. Like, it takes a lot of fucking effort.
It's a big deal. It's a fucking gift.
Yeah, they don't realize like
and
how
they,
lucky
and they should
they
be
are.
Eating it every time because, like I said, it's full of all these nutrients and vitamins, protein, everything the body fucking needs.
They should feel lucky that we want to come in their mouth.
That's what I'm saying.
Yeah. Chime in.
Hello.
Yeah.
What
go
the
ahead.
Fuck? The fuck is wrong with you? Okay, look, I get it. If I'ma suck some dick, I'm going to be a champ about it, and I'm going to swallow that shit, okay? Bitches spit, ladies swallow. However,
absolutely fucking agree on
calm
that.
Calm your
fucking
egos.
Agree.
Your fucking splooge is not a goddamn protein shake, okay? Like, no, I don't know. What the what is right? No.
So you
what,
swallow.
Just because you fucking say? I'll look up the fucking articles. I'll figure it out. I'll prove it to you.
And what is it with you guys
I'll prove
porn?
It to you that it's healthy for you. This is a good decision for
what
you.
What do you mean, you guys? Like, what are you talking about? Women love porn as much as fucking men.
In general, man.
No. Women like porn just as much as men.
I don't.
I hate this fucking stereotype that women like to put out that they're not, like, into porn as kinky
I'm
or, like, into sex as much as men are. Women love fucking sex just as much as men, and if there's any person in this room that would agree with me, that is you.
You're talking to a from about 4 a.m. to 6 a.m. fucking my boyfriend's brains out last night.
And so how am I wrong? You love sex just as much as I do.
I don't love porn though, man. I don't like porn.
Yeah, that's because you're an 18-year-old hot chick.
I don't like masturbation. It
on.
Just doesn't work for me. It's like playing a two-player game on one player. And then porn is like playing a simulator. I'd rather play the fucking game.
One thing, we've already said this on there, so I don't really feel bad saying it. Me and Ann need to not come home on Mondays, Renee. I'm just saying that right now. Don't come home on Monday nights.
What's this all about?
Oh, we have Porno Monday.
Porno Monday?
Porno fucking Monday.
Really?
Yeah, yeah. That's when we come together and we watch each other's porns.
How many of you?
Me and Ann.
Oh, just you and Ann?
Just me and Ann.
All right.
Yeah. Maybe, who knows?
Oh, okay, I mean, so you guys...
We're not against the idea of adding others to Porno Monday. I'd be down if other people wanted to join us.
So you two are separately watching your own porn. And then
on top of the amount of sex that we have.
And then when Porn Monday comes around, that's when you guys come together and you're like, hey, here's what I've been watching this week.
It's not so much is that what it is? We pretty much decide, we kind of go with the flow. So like the last time we watched porn, it was like Taboo Monday. It was like Taboo night. So we were all watching like, we kept trying to one up each other on like the taboo porn we can watch. Like, you know.
What was the worst thing that you could come up with?
I don't know. Usually after both we come, that's just like, that's it. When we're done, let's go to bed or something like that, you know. But last time it was father-daughter porn we're watching.
What?
Nice. Yeah.
Or what?
Stepdaughter. I'm quote unquote stepdaughter.
What?
Stepdaughter.
That's disgusting.
Yeah.
That's disgusting.
Like taboo porn. Yeah, yeah. How is that disgusting?
That's disgusting.
Taboo.
How is that not disgusting?
It might be, but it is most porn. Like, yeah. If you go to porno website, those are always the top things.
Stepsister, I'm literally nauseated.
And stepdaughter.
Also, what you with porn, and I didn't really realize this until like we started watching same tendencies. You kind of watch beginning to get the idea of what's going on, and then you skip ahead a little bit just to see what's going on, and then after that you skip ahead, but you don't skip ahead before the insertion. You gotta go right before the insertion point. And then you watch that through for a little bit.
Hashtag daddy issues. Anyways, you guys, I'm getting the fuck out of here. Check me out on AnarChicks. It's 10 to midnight on LRN.FM.
From the Rebel Love Studios.
From the Rebel Love Studios. Right. Peace out, douchebags.
This alert just came in. This
special What the fuck do you mean, what is wrong with me?
Rock bottom prices that could save you thousands. I'm just saying, that's don't come right. home on Monday Steel, nights, Renee.
In pre-engineered structures is offering buildings. The other nights I should.
You know, if you paid attention to like either one
of those.
Yeah, there's a lot of shit that goes on. Right. It's probably going to get worse, but it's better.
Manufacturers, if you need a larger building, try a 100 by 100 commercial building for $129,000.
What the fuck is going on with, like, Chroma Key on this? Like, I don't understand what's going on with this shot. From the long... Oh my god, I am so fucking thirsty. Hey, can you hand me Renee's fucking water?
Yes.
Oh, now it's fucking working. Now it's fucking working. Okay. I have to admit, you know, this computer is literally barely able to handle this. I love the way this looks, dude. This is what's going live to LRN, well, live to YouTube.
It's fucking...
You guys should see some people talking about in your chat right now.
Dude, everybody shows up to listen to my show. I know it sounds like I'm being a big deal, but kind of him on here.
You have been on LRN for a long time. You're
like a veteran now, man.
You're a vet. It's on LRN.
It's been like 3 or 4 years
now. I know, man. You've been on LRN for a long fucking time.
I started on LRN.FM. It was the 2012 elections.
You know, I remember Skyping into your... Okay, first of all, hey, FYI, I didn't tell you. I'm finally...
Oh, I think I heard about that, yeah.
Yeah, I'm finally fucking divorced. Left that fucking bitch. Oh, my God. We separated, like, over 2 years ago. Anyways, I remember after I separated, that's when I started Skyping into Off the Air Live. I remember Skyping in, and I was living in Chicago. Oh, my God, I was such a horrible time in my life, and I was on a vegan kick at the time. I was eating some like fucking vegan burrito, like smoking a joint in my apartment. take this studio and that kitchen. It was smaller than that. That's how big my apartment was in Chicago. And I remember, like, I left my job, and I would always listen to you and Corey Moore. I had to close, like, every Friday and Saturday night. And I would put TuneIn Radio on my phone. And I took the bus. I didn't have a fucking car.
Yeah.
And I would take the bus home from work, and it'd be 9 o'clock at night, which was 10 o'clock Eastern. Listen to you and Corey Moore every night on the fucking, like, 30-minute bus drive home.
Fucking awesome.
Yeah, we're on a commercial
for 4 minutes. You didn't say anything.
What?
I came in here and I flashed you. You didn't say anything.
You flashed me?
Yeah.
When?
Look, down
the I was not looking at you. Can you flash me one more time?
No,
did you really flash me?
I missed
you. I don't even remember coming. Hey, babe, can you close the door again? Because it's, like, blocking the camera.
Yeah, give me the
weed
back.
There's no more weed. Yeah, can you pack it? Can you pack more?
There is more.
What was the other gram? We bought 2 grams. I don't know. I had the gram in here and you took it.
Yeah, it's in there.
I only had the 1 gram. Where's the other gram?
I don't know.
I don't know either.
Babe, I don't think we smoked before we went to dinner.
She gave us 2 grams.
Yeah, and we smoked before we went to dinner.
No, the gram I took, I grabbed in here. I don't know where it's at.
I took it, and put it in that
when, okay, where's the other fucking gram? That's the gram we originally were smoking. We have a whole other fucking gram. Fine. Look, people, listen. For the 5 fucking viewers watching us live on YouTube, the struggle is fucking real. You don't even understand. She loses pot like it's no one's fucking business. It does. We blow through pot like it's no one's, like, it's fucking horrible. Like, time she's losing pot. She's losing all the fucking time. But anyways, if you want to change camera angles, one is just the logo with, like, this weird tripping. Okay.
Nice.
All right. 2 second delay when you switch camera angles because this computer sucks. You know, it's sold to us as if it was going to be fantastic. So, 3 I had deleted as a shot, so 3 is not actually not in existence. Switch to 2. 2. This is 2. Oh, we got 2 more minutes. Whenever there's a pause, I think there's a time frame. But 1 and 2 are the same. Back, if you go to 4.
Yep.
Supernova galaxy background really sounds cool when we're talking about, like, demons and shit like that.
Which we should.
Yeah. Speaking of, what are we fucking talking about when we're coming back? Do you even have show prep, or do you just, like, fucking wing it?
Nah, man. I wing it. All the time.
How often do you wing it? Because we literally need show prep all the time. We have, like, pages. Not pages, but we have, like, a
it's gonna
yeah,
sound
whole page of
it's gonna
prep.
Sound kind
of
weird, but you know what I do? Is, I talk in a way that puts me in kind of a flow state.
Okay.
Where I'm getting this stream of consciousness that kind of, like, comes through me. So, like, I can just talk about the government for, like, 10, 20 minutes. And I can just make those segues into places, like, randomly. Just by, like, having no filter in my brain and just splurting it all out, you know?
Okay. Interesting. No, we have to have show prep a lot, dude. We don't have a lot of show prep. We usually have a page of, like, it's usually just, like, highlights and shit like that. But we do that often. But I can't do, like, no show prep and do a 2-hour show. I don't know. First of all, where's fucking Michael? Like, your regular co-host. Where the fuck is he?
He's working tonight. He's got a new job now.
All right, I want to do a weird Snapchat. Check this out. So, this. It sees us on the green screen right there.
Yep.
And then go up. Turn around. Oh my god, we're in front of a green screen. Oh,
shit.
I left go of the... That's funny. I left go of the button. I don't know if I'm going to post it like that. I don't even give a shit.
good enough.
Yeah. But no, dude, seriously, I love. You need to get a high-end PC and do this, or just fucking move. You can use this studio. I really do want this to be like the Ellerine Liberty Media Capital of the world, not the studio. I just need shows coming out of it a lot.
Do you still have an open bedroom here?
It's time for the air line.
All right, everybody, coming into hour number two. Off the air live, hanging out on a Saturday night.
From the Rebel Love Studios.
From the Rebel
Vegas,
Love Studios.
Vegas, baby! And I just took some Adderall like an hour ago. I'm kind of feeling a little bit. I don't know if I'm feeling all of it.
I'm feeling a lot.
I'm excited about it.
I took a fucking lot.
I'm fucking excited about it.
I know. I feel like I would feel so much better if, like, we just took a break, went for a fucking run. You know what I mean?
We should
go
we
for a fucking run. We going do some push ups.
We should have done that in this last break. That was a long break. That was a 10-minute LRN break.
The next break, push ups.
I think that
for the entire break.
No, man, I'm sore.
For the entire break,
I did. Me and Ann are we're getting. If you didn't, well, you know, you're in a wedding party. But for the listeners on the LRN chat or what have you. Myself, my royal mistress, co-host of the fucking Rebel Love Show. I proposed to her at Porkfest. We're going to get married at Porkfest. And I kind of gained like about 20 pounds since I moved to the Shire. And I need to lose a little bit more weight. Pretty much more so for my haters hate me because I look good than anything else. But I also want to look good for, like, you know, wedding photos. And there's multiple instances, like the Big A Dance Party, and there's going to be a nude hike, which I hope, Cody, you join us with.
A nude hike, you say?
There is a nude hike. Not only is there a nude hike, but there's going to be a fucking Swedish tent sauna at the end of that fucking hike, all right? Stephanie Murphy's coming with us, and a bunch of other fucking people, all right? You need to join this fucking nude hike, but it's sometime during... And actually, the idea of this hike actually came about from a I think 2 or 3 weeks ago, we went out to Portsmouth to do some Uber activism.
Yeah.
And that Uber activism ended up going to like some free coasters millionaire's house where we were all fucking butt ass naked in a fucking Swedish sauna, and we're talking about like winners are gonna be a fucking nude like get together at Porkfest, because it's Porkfest. Like, who the fuck is gonna tell us to put on clothes? What are you gonna do? Call the cops on us? You know? And a nude hike came into play, apparently from that discussion, and now it's a thing. So be a nude hike, and there's a Facebook group where the entire of the group on Facebook is to promote getting in shape for that hike. So that is what I'm doing right now, and I did literally 100 push-ups yesterday and 100 crunches and like probably 15 minutes of planks. My entire body is just like sore as can be right now. My entire body, but that's my goal is to look good for Porkfest, absolutely, because I know I'm gonna be naked much of it.
Yep.
Yeah.
Especially if there's another dance party.
Of course, there's gonna be another
there
dance party.
There better be.
Like the Big A Dance Party at fucking Porkfest was incredible. Oh, I can't say it on air. I will during the break. I will tell you what me and Ann's costume is. Because last time we dressed in literally body paint and nothing more than like silver spandex. This year, our costume, mind you, no one's even stepped up to the plate for the Big Gay Dance Party, but we're assuming that there actually still is going to be a Big Gay Dance Party.
Fucking better be.
Oh my, it has to be. If there isn't, fuck, I'll stand up and like fucking run it. Like, there has to be another Big Gay Dance Party. Someone has to fucking organize it. I'll organize it. Someone else will organize it. Someone will take the mantle, organize that fucking party. Someone has to make that party happen. All right.
They could just do it in the field. Get a fucking speaker. I don't know, maybe start a bonfire and everybody just fucking dances around the fire like fucking pagan style. Dude, could you fucking imagine how fucking trippy that would be? Just raving on a fucking fire at Porkfest.
I would love
you're
that.
You're rolling your balls off. You're just dancing around a fucking fire.
I'm throwing out there right now. Next Porkfest is going to be trippier than the last Porkfest. More drugs will be used by more people. It'll be trippier. The dance parties will be fucking ravier. Like, everything's going to be more over the top.
You know what my belief is about Porkfest? You know, there's the daytime stuff, which is intellectual and kind of boring.
Yeah,
but the newbies.
The newbies go to Porkfest for the talks.
It's the first year people.
Yeah. The first ones.
All right, but when night comes around, it's sort of fucking like Burning Man, where everybody's changing their consciousness.
Oh my god!
And what they're doing is they're tripping balls in a place that's like culturally liberty minded, so it's like a totally different fucking vibe. You know what I mean?
Oh yeah.
So
I absolutely.
That's
agree.
Why it's sort of like Burning Man, because like it is kind of a drug festival when you think about it. You know, it's liberty people getting together, doing fucking drugs.
The only thing that sucks with Porkfest is that you get those conservative libertarians in there, like that stick up their nose, like
like the suit wearing types.
Yeah, like Shad Sexdome. All right, they're literally right next door to our campsite, so like we just literally walk next door to hang out. And I remember we were over there one night, and there are some people that came over. I think it was a Thursday night or something. I don't know. It was one of the later nights in the week where it's just every night in that during Porkfest is that fucking crazier and crazier. And there's like people that came over and asked them to turn the music down at midnight. And it was like a fucking Thursday night at Porkfest. And someone literally had the balls to walk in the fucking Shad Sex Dome and ask him to turn the fucking music down. And he fucking turned it all the way up. Like fuck you and turn the music up.
I'm sorry, man, but if you're coming to Porkfest,
it's a fucking party festival.
Yeah, part of the fucking deal is you might be by the Sex Dome. That might be where your tent site is. That's part of the fucking party, though. Yeah, you're not like, turn it down. I want to ruin your guys' fun.
I want to go to sleep at a normal hour at Porkfest. Who the fuck goes to Porkfest thinking they're going to sleep at a normal, rational hour? Like, who actually goes to Porkfest thinking that?
That was me the first year. Probably even the second year. It took me 2 years of being fucking bored and afraid of people with Melinda and just going to those daytime fucking things, going to bed early. We had a pod brownie one night. That was like the highlight.
Oh my god!
But this past year, when I came alone,
this is a great Porkfest.
This past year, when I came alone,
was fucking fantastic.
It was fantastic. First, fucking hippie flipped. As soon as I got there, that was like the first thing I did.
We shared a very special moment in a hotel room where we hugged for a while. You, me, and Anne.
I was feeling incredibly sentimental.
I remember.
I don't know what it is.
I remember.
Whenever I'm on that much MDMA, I just go around other couples, and I'm like, I want to be a part of your love. Bring me in.
I'm so glad though, I waited. Like I could have took some MDMA and hippie flipped on that, but that wasn't. I'll be honest. If I had taken MDMA prior to, I would have. But I knew damn well going forward that the big gay party was 2 nights later, and I had the willpower to hold off. I'm just gonna do the shrooms. I'm just gonna do the shrooms. Like, which was my first time doing shrooms. That was my first time doing shrooms that night.
Oh, that was awesome, because I remember when I first saw you that afternoon, you were talking about how fucking tired you were, you know? And then we take those mushrooms and like, you were off the fucking wall, dude.
Yeah, that was an intense moment. I remember that. That was a beautiful. We really went through a all around Porkfest. We started just walking around Porkfest, going through. I remember we were fascinated by Bill Domenico's fucking lasers.
Oh, dude. I remember reaching up and try and touch him too. I was like,
they're magical. Oh, they look so fucking magical. They look so fucking magical, like shooting through the sky. Yeah.
And then fucking Carlos Morales comes out of nowhere.
Oh, my God. Carlos Morales.
Triple balls. We're laughing. We're crying.
He came out of nowhere. His hair dated us while we're, like, fucking walking to, like, fucking Shad's sex dome or something like that. Like, we're leaving, like, the main,
beautiful fucking
Agra's
libertarian ballad. Whatever that was. It was a good time.
Yeah. That
Daniel Gaudreau was a stand-in for Ian Freeman.
And he almost won the
turned water into wine.
Yeah, he did. All right, we're on commercial break. Four Fist was fucking awesome, dude.
I think we've all had enough of that jingle, don't you?
It's fucking awesome out there. Dude, you missed it. You fucking did.
What, Keenvention?
No. Yeah, you missed fucking Keenvention.
Looking back, I fucking wish I was there.
It was fun, dude.
I still rolled that night. Just didn't get to dance really.
Let me show you something. Free press publication. All right, I'm going down. Media and publishing. Videos. Free YouTube. For the freedom movement and is committed to spreading the message of peace, free and liberty. Let me show you this. FPP also gives new. This was the fucking big party, dude. Look at this. Not big game. I'm sorry. The Halloween. This was the Halloween dance party where it was like, imagine this fucking party and hard. Like these lights everywhere, man. It was like, it was intense. It was so fucking intense. Those lasers. Imagine dancing around rolling hard on this, man. It was like you it was floating through lights and sound.
I can't even fucking imagine.
It was incredible. Johnson Rice videotaped a lot of this. It was cool. It was awesome. Halloween was fucking awesome. That was fun. But I'm so glad I waited to use MDMA for the big game. I want to use it a lot, save it for special moments.
Well, that's what you want to do, yeah.
Yeah. So the last time I used it was a Halloween, and the time before that, when was the time before that? The time before that, we have friends that are deep ranch, and they had a crazy party, and they're also DJing that night. So we May then went to their party. Before that was Hempfest, and then the time before that was now that you've found the Liberty Radio Network, I've only done it four times. MDMA, four times. To our great programs. That's it. To assist you in doing so, I say it's literally. I'm on target to do it one more time at the end of this month or next month.
For your website, as well. I need to pick some more up. I'm all out right now. And help bring new listeners. Holy shit! Network. That's
promoterrn.fm. On Free Talk Live, we're bringing people to the ideas of liberty every day. Superstars like Glenn Jacobs.
You guys really, I believe, like I said, a lot of where I am now is due to listening to Free Talk Live. You changed my mind on some very important issues years ago.
To random people tuning in on the radio.
I was kind of stuck in the left-right paradigm. I heard your show Saturday night. From there, I went on, joined the Free State Project, and become an amplifier. I mean, that's really the reason because I know that if it wasn't for you guys being on as many stations as you are, I never would have found the ideas.
Amp will directly change more lives by getting Free Talk Live in front of people looking for talk radio online and on. When you amp Free Talk Live, you get perks like access to the Amp Only Facebook group and Amp Podcast. Visit amp.freetalklive.com.
Listen to LRN.FM on any phone, anytime. 213-493-0309. That's 493-0309.
Alrighty, everybody, we are back. It is Off the Air Live show. Fucked up, man.
How fucked up are you?
Fucked up.
Fucked up enough.
Nah.
We can drink.
That's what I need to do. I'm thinking about.
All right. I can hold down the show for like the 40 seconds to a minute if you want to go grab some fucking vodka out of the fridge right outside the studio. That's all I got in the studio is some fucking vodka. We didn't come prepared. I'm already kind of drunk, so that's... But you didn't really drink much. I had two bowls of Thousand
I had
Crane.
One scorpion bowl.
I had two. Two scorpion bowls. And I've already smoked bowls as it is. So I'm kind of already there. But I'm down to take a couple of shots with you if you want to take a shot. Up all night because I'm on Adderall.
I bet you might actually pass out.
Hope not. I haven't pulled an all-nighter in a long time. Though the other night I kind of did, but that's because I just couldn't sleep. We ran out of pot the other night. And it sucks when you run out of pot because if you have insomnia, the easiest way to fall asleep is just bowl and like one two when you're passed out in 5 minutes.
Yep.
You know, and you can't really do that if you have insomnia and you don't have any fucking pot. And that's another thing. I want to go on a little rant for a second. As much as I love living here, oh my God, I don't know if it's New Hampshire, I don't know if it's New England, but pot dealers fucking New England. They fucking suck. They're like part-time pot dealers. They some quality product in stock, but normally they don't. They don't actually. I'm used to actually, before I moved, I could actually, you know, maybe pick, like have a choice of like Sour Diesel or Kush or something like that, you know, like Apple Express, whatever. I can actually choose like what strand I'm buying, you know. I can actually sativa and whatnot. Like I can actually choose different strands. Here it's literally fucking good.
Yep.
That's normal. Sometimes they might have a choice, but it's really rare. And you're like a $10 premium. I'm used to paying $40. $40 for an eighth. And it was quality pot. It was like high-end Kush. And I had multiple dealers that would deliver to my apartment. They would literally come to my front door, come in, chill, hang out, smoke me up, and leave. Multiple. That would do that. Here, it's another story. Here, you find people that do this part-time, which they maybe, I don't know if they're like part-time drug dealers that think it's a hobby, that, hey, it's cool, I'm a drug dealer. I get this pot and maybe have some extra pot on the side for myself. You know, and they're literally just paying for their habit instead of actually shit. And they're serious that this is my business and I do this for a living.
Yeah.
You know, and I... And it's very disappointing. Very disappointing. So I'm not impressed by the dealers in New England at all.
Dude, it doesn't really bother me either way. Like, fucking weed is weed, you know?
No.
It really is. Like, it gets me fucked up. It doesn't... I'm not picky about what weed I get, you know? So I guess I'm, like, kind of used to... around here.
I will say this, I have found a fantastic edible dealer every single time, and I've never had this with an edible dealer. An edible dealers and pot dealers are two different types of people, because normal there's like hardcore pot dealers and there's like hardcore edible dealers where like they're like great ways of doing brownies and cookies and stuff like that, you know, like that's their trade. Like baking is their trade. Like just selling pot as a trade, but every now and then you find an edible dealer that just is. And my idea of incredible is I'm not saying someone that knocks it out every now and then. I'm talking about someone that's consistently batting 300. To use a sports analogy, where every you take you get one a product of theirs, you know that you're gonna be good for the next like 4 hours. Oh, you're going to be great. You're going to be fantastic. Everything's going to be fine. You know, you have something to look forward to. People you get edibles from, they're like, you might have a grand slam. They might, you're floating in air and just laughing hysterically for the next hour, or it's going to be a dud, and that's it. You know, this person, I took an edible last night, right after, before I slept the Anarch Chicks on LRN.FM.
Oh, there you go.
Yeah.
How often are you doing this?
Edibles? It's every now and then. When I have a, see, that's the thing. The source that I have that makes edible, once a month, there's a quantity available. But I know from experience every time that I buy quality products. So, like, when they're available, I'll buy them. And I'll usually buy, like, 5 edibles. Just because I want to be able to, I only take usually one a week, limit myself to one a week. So I have a freezer or in the fridge just to last me. And I'll take like one a week. And me and Ann, we never fucking go to the movie theaters. We never fucking go to, we have better things to do than go. Have more experience than actually going to movie theaters. But we like the Hunger Games. So I'm like, well, fuck, I've had this brownie sitting in my for weeks. Like, why not? I'll take it and go watch the Hunger Games. So I saw the last Hunger Games. I took before. I saw the movie an hour and a half before. And it started to hit really hard about 20 minutes into the movie. 20 minutes in. I don't really remember much of the movie, but I remember I enjoyed it, except for fucking Peeta. Peeta, if you see the fucking Hunger Games, that guy, oh my god, wow, it's tripping ball. Not tripping ball, is really good. But compared to normal pot, on an edible trip, all I can think about is Conan O'Brien skits where they take like the face of Arnold Schwarzenegger and they have the, you know, someone else talking in front of that guy's face and you see the lips move. That's what I think of that actor. Every time that actor came on the fucking screen, all I can think about is, oh my god, why are his lips, face not moving? It just seemed horrible, and I was freaking out about it in the theater. I was elbowing and like, oh my god, they need to kill this character off before I freak out. Like, I fucking hate that character. I don't really remember much about the movie, and even that, I don't really remember much. But it was a good trip. I remember enjoying it.
Sounds like you had a good time.
It was fucking fantastic. Also, already smoked like 3 bowls before I even saw the movie. So
do you ever just do an and close your eyes and see where it fucking takes you? If you do that, it can be kind of trippy, man.
I really like using edibles on Porno Mondays.
Sounds like a good time.
It's a fucking,
with Adderall, I swear to god, you'll have the time of your fucking life.
I'm hoping. We'll find out soon after the break.
Report back to me. Every once in a while. Oh, man, am I fucked up.
How fucked up are you, dude? How much Adderall did you... Adderall did I take? What should I be prepared for?
You didn't take nearly as much as me, but I'm, like, fucking really jittery right
now. I can tell. How much did you take?
Fucking 90 milligrams.
Is that a lot? 90 milligrams?
That's a fucking lot. Yep.
Why did you take that much?
Because I want to have a really good time tonight.
Okay.
You know?
Fair enough. What do you want?
Good reason.
What do you want to do tonight?
Told you. We're going to get done. We're either going to go somewhere or we're going to put on fucking fast techno and just, I don't know.
We can get more. If Anne can fucking find the other pot that we fucking bought.
That's true.
Worst case scenario, we can go. So I'm not too worried about it.
All right.
But... oh, do you want a drink? Do you want?
You got anything to mix it with?
I might. I don't know. It's alcohol. Who gives a shit?
Yeah, fuck it.
Do you want a couple shots?
I'll do a shot.
A shot.
See how I feel.
All right. Let's go grab it. I'm gonna throw this on. Change the camera angles. or whatever. Pretty much just leave it between 1 and 5. At Survivor
Max. Remember, we came back money in like 2 minutes.
It's at credit, success secrets review.com. DScene is an industry leader.
In 3 minutes.
The last application you filled out, when it was time to hit submit, your nerves spike. You didn't get the approval, but there's a better way. We teach you exactly what to place into the right systems the right way the first time, so you get up to $100,000 in instant business credit. Many people will get cash on the spot. Use those two tools, Corporate Credit Engine, so you can walk into the bank and get your project funded today. It's all about today at Credit Success Revealed.com. Credit Success Secrets Revealed is explosive and ignites instant results. Dial 1-800-719. That's 1-800-707-8719. 1-800-707-8719. Or just go to creditsuccesssecretsrevealed.com.
LRN.fm is proud to announce our official Android and iOS devices. Now you can easily tune into our streams anywhere, anytime on your smartphone or tablet. Just LRN.fm or search for LRN.fm in the Android or Apple app stores. Click download, rate it 5 stars. Link on social media and let your friends and family know how you're listening to LRN.fm. Download it now, free at FM. That's apps.lrn.fm.
Understanding your credit score is the first step towards
what are you doing?
This is Charlie Sunstrom with your Van Dyke Mortgage Minute.
Taking it all
the
in.
Most influential you're component what of your credit score is the amount you owe on credit accounts.
Whatever, dude.
Also impacting your score, but to a lesser degree, are the length of time you've utilized, the number of new accounts, credit inquiries, in your various
types of
credit accounts.
Alright, do you want a shot out of the Street Fighter
max out your cards,
class? Or the glass that isn't Street Fighter. I thought I grabbed two new video game ones, but I didn't.
But don't be Street Fighter's good for me, man.
You need several.
But the vodka will clean it.
Just keep the corresponding payments within your means. For your mortgage pre-approval and refi needs, start by mortgage.com.
Corporate NMLS 3035. Van Dyke Mortgage is an equal housing lender.
I'm actually kind of scared to take it, to be honest. I don't fuck up.
Yep.
If you enjoy LRN.FM, please contribute to your
favorite show. Can we at least do a cheers on
and become an amplifier at
love show commercial yet.
LRN.FM.
Yeah. Plays on my show. I read that. All right, man. We are back.
We are back, and we didn't even get to take a shot during the break.
So what are we doing? Are we doing the shot right now?
Doing on air, sure. Why not? Why the fuck not? Ash is back in the studio. She always approves of me drinking. That's why I love this cat. She's the best studio cat the world has ever seen. All right, let's do a shot. Don't you have like a shot song or something like that?
Take a shot of beer with me.
I hate shots. I hate the initial but I really don't give a shit afterwards. It's pretty much smoking pot. I actually hate the act of smoking. I can't fucking stand it. But afterwards, I don't mind. Same thing with MDMA. Unless it's actually taking MDMA. But afterwards, I fucking love it. It's the exact same thing.
It doesn't fucking taste good.
No. Why does stuff that makes you feel good taste horrible? Why, if there is a God, why would they God do that to us? Why would they punish us to make us feel good?
I don't know.
It doesn't make any sense. Wait, close the door. She didn't even hear me. Oh, no, she did. Okay, there we go. The rebel mistress just fucking flashed us. It wasn't like, okay. And also, by the way, if you are listening to LRN.FM, go to rebelloveshow.com/offtheairlive.com, which is a great website, which you should bookmark if you haven't done so already. It should be your homepage by now.
Wait, let me say this right now. Get on the fucking Facebook group.
Oh, off the air live group. Yeah, yeah, dude. That's a fun group.
Yeah, join the OTAL club.
The OTAL group.
There's a lot of shit going on in there.
We had a Rebel Love group. That's past drama from my show. We don't have a group anymore. It was stolen.
Just, dude, bring your people to the OTAL club and grow. We can become the cool people of the Liberty Movement just fucking hanging out.
Just hanging out.
All in one group.
All right, maybe. Maybe I'll convince my go to that. Hey, do you ever have at your job coming up to you, like coworkers, people you've worked with for like the last year? Do you, I know you work in radio, so maybe you do have this. Do you have coworkers coming up to you talking to you about like a episode of Off the Air Live?
I didn't have that happen to me, but my boss found out and started playing an episode while I was right there. Like,
which episode was it?
I was just fucking God that it wasn't about masturbation or how I don't give a shit about 9/11. It turned out it was like a episode. Thank fucking God.
Oh my God.
Because that could, dude, that could have been bad.
Well, I've been very open with people at work that, oh my God, I've been open with so much fucking shit with people. I've been open with the fact that I am, do a radio show. I've been openly, all right? I have not been openly a freestater. The only other way I can explain it was I was a freestater, but I have not actually yet. I came very close at a work party where they're asking me about, like, why the fuck did you move here? You know, like, how the fuck do I explain it?
It's pretty much the entire reason, so.
Yeah. I've come very close without actually.
Not much day.
The other day, I had a coworker, an awesome guy. Awesome guy. But he's very New England. Very typical New England, like, gracios to him. And he kind of talks in a monotone voice, and he came over to me, and he goes, I went to the RebelLoveShow.com, and I watched an episode, and I watched that dating episode. We did an episode in early October on Tinder activism. Me and Ann were critiquing each other's fucking online profiles.
I actually listened live to that.
On our KC, like on our OK Cupid profiles. And I had a coworker literally come and start talking to me about our episode about Tinder and OK Cupid. Really awkward and weird. To have, like, the fact that I didn't show him, I didn't give him my website. I didn't, like, that. He just brought up in conversation. Never gave him my website. I never actually, they knew I did a radio show. They didn't need the website. It was on Facebook at the time. And he started watching the show from hearsay.
Cool, man.
It's not weird than anything else. I also get recognized at work a lot. I get recognized at work, considering I live in Manchester and I have a huge fucking neck beard, which is sexy as hell if you haven't paid it at home. Right here, if you're watching on rebelloveshow.com/live, very sexy beard test here. I get asked if I'm a freestater at work by, like, customers. I work sales, so I'm in front of like public like that. And I have these tattoos on my arms and stuff like that. I get asked if I'm a freestater at least once a month, maybe twice a month. It's really weird. I don't know if I should say yes or no, because I don't want to piss them off. Because it's a customer, I got to sell to them, so I don't want to say yes, because I might actually, like, sell them shit that pays my fucking paycheck. I don't want to say yes, because I'm afraid they'll, like, not buy anything from me because they hate freestaters. So I haven't had that conversation with management, which I have... No management on my Facebook right now. I don't know about you. Do you have your bosses as friends on Facebook?
No. I would. Who does that? I would never add my fucking boss.
Who would?
Terrible idea.
It's a horrible idea. Especially for me. I talk about sex, drugs, and anarchy on my Facebook page more often than not. I mean, seriously, more often than not, I talk about sex, drugs, and anarchy. And how can I have my bosses from a Fortune 500 company as friends on Facebook? You know my boss is fucking rock. I actually love my management team, but I would never add them as a friend on Facebook. Like, fuck no.
Nope.
Fuck no. I mean, hell, I made a post the other day about how I was, like, hugely pissed off. It was like the, I forget their names, but there's this couple in New Hampshire, like, 5 years ago, where they're put in jail for 30 and 35 years respectively for avoiding taxation. They literally just didn't pay their income tax. And there's like a 2-month standoff where they were eventually their house was raided, they were kidnapped by the IRS, and now they're in a cage for the next 30 years of their life because they didn't pay off the fucking federal government. Fuck those fucking bastards, by the way. There's a post in the Union Leader where they were auctioning off their property, their home, their cars, and shit like that. And it was just so fucking despicable that because these two people stood up and said, no, fuck you, I ain't paying, I'm not going to allow you to steal from me anymore. They kidnapped them for fucking 30 years and sold off their fucking property for profit. And I made a huge post about that. Like, fuck these bastards for kidnapping these people and selling their property, stolen property for profit. That's not something you want my managers to see.
No, man.
Like, who the fuck want their management? Like, people that can have the ability to fire you. Why would you want them to see shit like that? I mean, between me and you, that seems like a normal thing that people would say. But when it comes to muggles, that's a whole other bag of wax. I wouldn't get into it if you want when we come back from the break, but you only have one break left. I can tell you about like a whole Tinder experience I had with a statist.
Let's do it. More coming up, everybody.
Roberts and Roberts.
In early trading Thursday, gold is even at $1,082 per ounce. Silver is 2 cents lower at $14.50 per ounce. Bitcoin is trading at $322. We have the lowest priced Australian spiders on the web. If you find them cheaper, we'll match that price and ship.
I have been tagged in a post by
874. Visit online at rrbi.co.
Do you get tagged in posts a lot?
Yep. Roberts and Roberts Brokerage celebrated the
party leader Patterson faces with a profit of that day's
sales to anti-war.
A lot of Facebook all the time.
This offer again on Bitcoin Black Friday, November 27th. Shop online at rrbi.co on Black Friday, and Roberts and Roberts will donate the profit of the day's sales to anti-war.com. Anti-war committed.
No, seriously though, Anne started hey, can I get a cigarette? I smoked a cigarette in a long time. Remind me to give you money for Adderall, but I'll bum a cigarette. I'll smoke you with if Anne's found that other. Muchas gracias, senor. Because I really ever actually smoked cigarettes.
Instead of just listening, you can also watch. See the Liberty Radio Network's keen.
But seriously, I really do want the studio to be
LRN.fm.
Like, this has the opportunity to be like the LRN cap, like the Liberty. And our chicks are going to be recording here Friday night. We record Tuesday nights. Ann already does Flaming Freedom for maybe when Derek J and Steven move, which is in the spring. Studio as well. You're welcome to use this whenever you do your show. If you do move, I want the studio to be used for other stuff too, like videos, interviews, whatever. a lot of stuff can happen with the screen and shit like that. Like, with four, my teeth were I want this to be used. iMagicMud.com, buy a jar.
There's 150 applications for $25. You can use Bitcoin, my.com.
The three most important things you can do for LRN.FM
are: 1. Let your friends know you're listening to FM on your social networking profile. 2. Buy the things you buy online through shop.lrn.fm. 3. Month to the AMP program at amp.lrn.fm. You likely buy all kinds of things online. Amazon is the largest.
Man.
You can get what you need at the same great prices, and LRN gets a cut. Please do your online shopping at shop.lrn.
Was at dinner. I don't know if you were there. No, you went there. Did I tell you me and Anne and Amy? Oh my God, right in front of fucking Thousand Crane, dude. Like, we're walking up. We're walking up to Thousand Crane. Recognize her first because she dyed her hair. Oh, Robin Ann.
CBS executives are touting the broadcast as breakthrough programming for people who are excited by the top.
Imagine walking up with at the time, and it was your, both of your exes. So both of you are like, when you run into your ex, you know you have a, like an open. It's still awkward being around them for like the first time. That was the first time either one. No, that's the second time I saw her because. Month later, I like message her like, "Hey, you gotta pick up some of your shit. Like, you still love you left like, some clothes and shit like that."
This is the Onion News Network.
You can put the Liberty Radio Network on the air. We got 30 seconds. But yeah, Anne ran into Amy for the first time right before you got there.
Just enjoying having some less than Jake and me right now.
I fucking love Scott. I you have the best bumpers on LRN, bar none. Well, except for the Rebel Love Show, but
this fucking other song
than that,
I'm such a fan.
I love Scott music.
Just nervous in the alley.
I love happy music. Maybe that's one reason why I've really started to love house music and like. Electronic music, maybe it's more because I do more drugs than I used to ever do, but
I think that totally is what's going on. Like,
it just makes you feel happy. I love feeling happy. Music makes me feel happy. Music and ska music does that too.
Ska does it. Fucking EDM is really doing it for me right now. Seriously,
fucking ska music. I love EDM.
Last time you came up, I showed you fucking Bass Nectar. You remember that shit?
Yeah. Bass Nectar rocked. Yeah.
I got fucking blazed listening to fucking Bass Nectar. So good.
You know, I'm still going to hold you to it, but you did miss Zach Deputy. And Zach Deputy like amazing, happy music. But I can't get in regards to happy music and EDM, it's an EDM, but in regards to like electronic music, I cannot, and Renee, behind it, and she fucking plays that shit all the time. I cannot get behind happy hardcore. It's just too much. It's like fucking NES game is having epilepsy. Like that's what like when it comes to happy hardcore music.
I'm so with you. It's fucking awful. It's
bad. It's like
music.
My childhood. It's bad music. It's like my childhood is like dying of like you know literally like have heart attack or like I love Zelda music and I love NES games, but do I want to dance to that shit? Fuck no. Why would I want to dance to like, you know, like a Pikachu song or something like that? Fuck that.
Nope.
Like I love fucking dance music, and in the last year I've really discovered that I really love fucking dance. Me and Anne have an actual exercise routine where we would do like an hour and a half and just dance in the 360. We're old school. We only have an Xbox One or a PS4. Fuck that. We have a fucking old school Xbox 360 and like a $20, and we play a $5 Just Dance 3 game, and we're like doing, I've been her like three times. The majority of time I don't beat her, but I went about 40% of the dances. 10 year older white guy with a beard. I should show that I'm bringing fucking game. You know, I'm not meeting the stereotype of an older guy with a beard, and I'm still being this like 10-year-old that can dance her ass off. And I'm still bringing game to her, and I win about 40% of the matches.
Well, there you go.
Well, I mean, I have to look. The Pork Fest is coming. All right. And my dance game. If I'm ever gonna win the best dancer, K Lords at the Big Gay Dance Party. So I gotta do what I can. Which I didn't tell you what our our costume is, but I can't tell you. I'll tell you off the air. Off the air live. I will tell you once we're off. I can't give the secret away because everyone will know because everyone listens off the air.
But you better actually tell me this time. Last time you didn't.
I will tell you, but you have to pinky swear that you never fucking. All right, because it's that fucking good. The only problem is there is a possibility that Anne might emcee that convention Halloween dance party, which she did a fucking incredible job emceeing. But if she's a. Because Buzz, for those that go to Pork Fest, Buzz is not doing the Big Gay Dance Party anymore. No one's home yet. I'm hoping the Gaynarchist group on Facebook steps up to the game, or like maybe Derek Che, but somebody steps up to the game because there has to be another Big Gay Dance Party.
It's got
to
be.
Yeah, I mean, you don't have to be Big Gay Dance Party. You can be pansexual too, or actually straight. Just dress as with the least amount of clothes. Take some fucking MDMA and fucking rage your fucking ass off in the fucking White Mountains in a tent with a bunch of fucking close to naked people and dance your ass off. That's what you gotta do. And hopefully that party next year doesn't end in mid, because it was a horrible ending to that party.
Dude, I know. The lights just fucking came on.
Yeah, the lights turned off. Oh, by the way, we're done for the night. Like, oh my god, when you're rolling on MDMA and you're in that. Why did you want the party to stop? That's what was fucking great about the Halloween dance party. It lasted until 1:30, and it was daylight savings time, so theoretically they could have got a little bit like extra hour in if they really wanted to, but hour and a half longer than the Big Gay Dance Party or from Halloween the previous year.
Why?
Oh yeah, absolutely. But no, I need to get in shape. Dance party before the naked walk. If you're going to Pork Fest, there's going to be a naked hike. Facebook, the get into that group. If you want to walk naked with me and a bunch of other porks, you just let me know. I'll get you into the group. We embrace nudity with open arms. So feel free to walk around naked with us. But that is Pork Fest. So I need to lose a couple pounds right here, build up my muscle mass. You know,
you'll be good.
Well, on top of that, I gotta look good for the wedding, man. I gotta look good for the fucking wedding. You're part of the party. You already tone a little bit. You don't have to lose any weight. I gotta lose about fucking 20 pounds, but that's gonna come after Thanksgiving. I'm gonna do low carb.
There you go.
Yeah, I can't do it right now. I gotta wait till after low carb, and I'm only gonna do it for like a month, lose 10 pounds really quick, exercise a shit ton, be okay, hopefully.
Yeah.
Well, I lost 110 pounds before I moved. I used to be 320 pounds, 48-inch waist, before, I'm sure. I lost all that fucking weight. If I did that, I can do that now. And it feels like I did that like 10 years ago, but 3 years ago.
Hmm.
It's really weird the amount of time that changes between now and then. You're gonna go to the Pork Fest, right? What are you gonna dress as for the big party? You even have that plan? Do
I have no idea?
You gotta plan now, man. You gotta think ahead. You gotta have a good costume idea. More, less is always more. You also have to get unique, something very, very unique. You can't, you just can't just go with the flow. Though Daniel last year deserved to win with the TSG costume.
Dude, I totally agree.
Yeah, he earned that. He almost won Halloween dance party. The Halloween dance party.
I fucking saw the pictures.
He went as the prophet. Peace be upon him. He went as him, as Ian Freeman, from the Big Gay Dance. How fucking niche is that? Like, that's super fucking niche. That's way beyond niche. And
bullshit.
Okay, he didn't win because Renee fucking blew it out. He had a dance off to see who had won, and she actually busted her ass to be the corpse bride. And she was a corpse bride, I won't lie. But her dance at the end, she literally ripped off her fucking wig, put in the air as if like, fuck yeah, I fucking won, and literally threw her fucking wig, you know, as like a mic drop. Like, it was fucking incredible. And that's why she won the contest from that party, because her dance deserved the fucking win. Though I will say, runner up, Derek J dressing up as a Asian schoolgirl. He had Johnson Rice actually videotaped this, where almost everyone at that dance party came over and spoke. It's on fucking YouTube. If you want to go check it out, go on YouTube and see a bunch of people dance party spanking Derek J's ass. That was fun, and he should have. Isn't for Renee. He was the third runner up, but if he definitely probably won for that costume. He outdid himself from Marilyn Monroe the year before. Anyways, before we end the break, I just want to say go check out the RebelLoveShow.com.
All right, everybody, thank you for listening. Sorry I was so fucking stoned this whole time, but we'll see you next week. Good one, everybody.
Peace.